side for you. And I put links on both wrists. If you got control over me, and you got no sight, you don't need love, baby. We don't need law. Follow my lead forward.
I'm back in New York. This is my sublet for the next 1 month. It's an apartment here in Chelsea. The view is crazy. I've never had a view that wasn't just a wall. You could actually see the Empire State Building. Again, this is just temporary housing. I officially finalized my long-term 1 year living spot, and I'm gonna be moving there at the end of the month. But since I just came back from Guam a week ago, I needed more time to, you know, figure that out. This is the bathroom, kitchen. I keep bouncing around Airbnbs ever since I moved to New York. Yeah, I noticed it wasn't until I started YouTube where roommates and who you live with is such a big deal. So stay tuned. This is my apartment. So I'm in Lower Manhattan right now, about to get a haircut. It's been a while, but this is not just any haircut. There's this TikTok account. It's called 12 Pel, and they're a barbershop here in Chinatown. They're really good about hair consultation, hair tips. So I actually just DM'd them and I was like, can I get a cut? That's where I'm going right now. I always have an issue with barbers cutting my hair too short, so I'm excited to see how this goes. This is the before. Here we go.
Ever thought about joining like a K-pop band or something?
Too Filipino, I think. So most of my life, I've always had really short, very Filipino type comb over. And I always noticed, in hindsight, I look back and like, wow, that just did not match my head shape.
Yeah.
It wasn't until COVID, I was like, let me try growing it out. BTS, I would look at them and like, yeah, yeah. You know, what if I tried doing a middle part?
The widest point of your head is actually the forehead.
Forehead, yeah.
And so if I put my finger right here, ideally you want to bring it in tighter so that the head shape doesn't continue to become wider. Talk to me, what's next?
I don't need it too short. I like the middle part, so I want to keep that. In general, not too short for both the top. Yeah. The side.
I'm really liking this style. I think you truly just need a maintenance trim. How do you typically style your hair?
Like that?
Just like that.
And then I'll, like, yeah. I'll do this.
Oh, okay.
And then that's pretty much it.
And let's wrap it up by spinning you in a chair.
Thank you, Pete.
Of course, anytime. Hit us up on Instagram, 12pel.
At 12pel. You was cruising with your top down, 4th of July. I was moving down the block. We got caught at the light out my window. I was shooting my shot. Watching fireworks in the sky. Thank you, 12pel. That was amazing. I got a new look. Today, I am gonna be going to meet up with my friend, and we're gonna go thrifting for the first time in New York. I haven't gone thrifting in New York yet. You know, I just figured new hair, time for some new clothes as well. I have like an hour to kill. I'm next to a coffee shop, Now or Never, one of my favorite spots in the city. Anyway, last night I was watching some of my old videos, like my vlogs back in LA. It was really interesting that I could go back into a certain time period and see what my life was like. What's interesting about it was my biggest roadblock as a YouTuber is coming up with new ideas every week. Specifically for my genre of YouTube, it's like lifestyle vlogging, personality lifestyle vlogging. And I would go into these phases of things. Like, for example, I was living with skaters, Luke and Natalie, and there was like 4 or 5 vlogs where I would go to the skate park with them every day in my vlog. And at the time, I was thinking like, oh man, I'm going to the skate park again. Like, it's so repetitive. But only looking back, because I don't do that anymore, and I totally forgot that that was a thing that I did in my life where I was skating like all the time. Or even something as simple as like going to the WeWork or driving in my old Honda Civic. Only now that I'm at this entirely new chapter in my life, looking back, I'm so glad I filmed that. It's like I get this like bird's eye view of like my past 2 years, whatever's online. What's the point of this? What was the point? I'm gonna turn this into a lesson. You should film, take photos, and take videos more, because your life might seem repetitive right now, but what if you move cities or your life changes? That's about it. That's all the lessons I have. I'm gonna go get some coffee.
Oh, hey, what's up? Thank you.
Is this saying vanilla ice?
It is.
Oh, latte? Oh,
no. Yes. I'm calling it now. I'm calling it now. I'm calling it now. You'll find love with me somehow. Yes, yeah, somehow. I'm calling it now. Hi guys, do you want to introduce yourself?
I'm Issa.
I met Issa in 2020 in LA. We actually both moved here from California just this summer, so thanks for coming.
Of
Boom.
Course.
So we're thrifting for the first time, and we are in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, heading to a place called Stella Dallas.
Let's see what we pick out for you.
I'm gonna tell you my goals. So a top and a bottom, okay. And a necklace. How would you describe my style?
Classic Asian.
Asian. Duh. Is this Asian? Fellas, is this Asian?
Asian YouTuber.
It's so funny.
I don't like those.
Me neither.
So a trick you can do is you can put it around your neck, and then this is the same as your waist size.
My dad taught this to me. Did you guys know this hack? Comment below. I thought this was general knowledge.
Oh, this looks good. Okay, get that one. Yeah, that's cool.
All right, let's go. You were shy, but you told me to pull over, and now I'm right behind you.
We should buy both.
You gonna get it for me? No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, I will. No, I will. No.
Are you sure? Okay, well, if you change your mind, just request me.
That was just for the video.
Okay.
I thought you turned it off again.
Yeah.
Just make that.
Yeah. Wait. I'm confused.
I was joking just now.
Wait, what?
Did you believe
really?
Me?
Yeah.
I thought you were joking as well.
Are you sure?
That was so funny. I was so funny. We're going back to the store so that I could change into the outfit so we could take photos here. It's a nice street.
Yeah, pick it up. Like, go like this. Oh. No, what's the ground?
Oh. They've been traveling and they're back in town.
Yes.
I'm gonna show them my outfit.
Let's go.
So it's these pants that I'm wearing.
Oh,
oh,
nice.
They're corduroy.
Good, get everybody.
Ooh, good for the winter.
Good for the winter. It's very warm.
Nice.
Proof. Anything? 280 jacket for 80 bucks. It's pretty good. Win. And then I bought Issa a jacket for helping me out.
Yay.
Got me a jacket. Cause I went shopping with him.
Where's our jackets, Jed?
Yeah, Jed.
Jed impersonation. Mm-hmm.
Wow, this is a wake-up call. Is that what people see me as?
Everyone's just chilling, typing, and you're, we work like this.
You gotta smile permanently.
You're like, oh wait, the laugh.
I'm holding in my laugh just now. Just so. I think that's enough for the vlog. Closing message, see you next week.
Damn, really?